In this video, we are going over the external features of the heart. We're going to start with noting the anterior view and the posterior view, which is the front, and in this case, the back of the heart. Our first vessel is going to be the inferior vena cava. That is this structure right through here. So that'd be the vein plugging into this portion, number 20. We're going to go to the superior vena cava, which requires us rotating back to the anterior view of the heart. This segment of this vein is going to be the superior vena cava. We're going to have the right and left brachiocephalic veins. These branch off to the left and right jugular veins. So for the exam, just make sure you note that the jugular veins branch off these two brachiocephalic veins. Next, we're going to have the ascending aorta. So we're going to remove the front half of this heart, put it right over here, and we're going to note that this is the ascending aorta. This is where the oxygenated blood is going to be pushed out up into this segment of the aorta. So we're going to have the ascending aorta, then we have the aortic arch, and we're going to kind of rotate the heart a little bit so you guys can see it. This is the aortic arch, and off the aortic arch, we're going to have three major vessels. We're going to have the brachiocephalic artery, the left common carotid artery, and then we're going to have the left subclavian artery. So because there's two lefts, there should be two rights, and they actually branch off this brachiocephalic artery right here. Next, we're going to have the descending aorta. So we followed the arch, and the descending aorta is going to be the segment that continues down from here. Next, we're going to talk about the right and left coronary arteries. So we're going to rotate back to this view where we see the ascending aorta. This is going to be the right coronary artery. This is going to be the left coronary artery. Now we're going to put the front of the heart back on so we can see where those two vessels come from the front of the heart. And their job is to supply oxygenated blood to the actual cardiac muscle. So this is going to be the right coronary artery that comes out through here. This is going to be the left coronary artery. And once they come out, they actually branch off into smaller segments, and we'll go over what those segments are. So first we're going to talk about the anterior cardiac vein. And we know that this is going to be the anterior cardiac vein. It's this little segment that comes right out through here. And its goal is to bring the deoxygenated blood, the used blood, back to be reoxygenated. So we have the coronary sulcus. And the coronary sulcus is going to be the groove that goes all the way around the heart where the arteries and veins sit in. So remember, sulcus, that sink-in portion. Next, we're going to have the anterior interventricular sulcus. So anterior latina location, interventricular. So this is going to be that first branch that continues straight down from the left coronary artery. So the anterior interventricular branch of the left coronary artery is going to be right here. Okay, next we're going to talk about the coronary sinus. And so we're going to, and by the way, there's a sulcus that this artery actually sits in. So we're going to rotate back to the posterior view of the heart. And this is the coronary sinus. It's nice and big, significantly bigger than the great cardiac vein, which is going to be right through here. And so we're going to rotate actually to the front to kind of show you its path. So this is the great cardiac vein. So it's bringing deoxygenated blood all the way around right under this left auricle, back where it empties into the coronary sinus. Next, we're going to talk about the pulmonary trunk. So we're going to go back to the anterior view again. And this is where that deoxygenated blood is going to come from the right ventricle and be pushed up before it breaks off into the left and then right pulmonary arteries. And these are the ones that are going to eventually break off and go into the lung to be reoxygenated. Next, we're going to have the left and right auricles. This is going to be the right auricle. This will be the left auricle. We're going to talk about the, so we talked about the anterior interventricular artery, which sits in the anterior interventricular sulcus. We're going to go to the back, where we have the posterior interventricular sulcus, but we're also going to have the posterior interventricular artery. And this is going to be the middle cardiac vein. We're going to have the circumflex artery and the marginal artery. We're going to go back to the anterior view. So remember we talked about the left coronary artery, how we have the anterior interventricular artery, but you see this little branch here that kind of curves under this left auricle. This artery right here is the circumflex artery. The marginal artery is going to be right through here. And so we know that this is the right coronary artery. Its first major branch is going to be the marginal artery, and that's that's about it.